All right, what is going on, and happy holidays. We are here with the SP1200, of course, the classic drum machine. And today we are going to look over simple sound design, very elemental sound design. And usually sound design will involve taking something completely unrelated and changing it into something that you want. However, there is incredible valuable in taking things that are already in the ballpark of what you want and reprocessing them through simple means. And that is what we're going to look at today. And before we do that, it is a super loaded day today. We have episode 57 of the Samplers Podcast, which is live right now. A special interview with Shiro Fujioka, aka Voltage Controller, aka the godfather of mod BAP. If you've been hearing mod BAP here and there and you're wondering what it is, where did it come from, who is responsible for it, this is the interview you're going to want to listen to. Incredible interview all across the board. Now, in addition to that, today, update 1.1 of the S950 operational manual has been added. If you have an S950, are thinking about getting an S950, or just want to know how to master the S950, this is the manual for you, with even more value now that update 1.1 is added. Information in the description box below. Now, on to what we're doing. Using percussive elements from an outside acoustical source is a great way to start taking your sounds into the more otherworldly realm, right? Usually when we have acoustic instruments, they kind of sound fixed in their ways. You can reference them to their source. However, when you use vintage samplers like the SP1200 to slightly alter them through basic means, you get to add another life onto these acoustic instruments. So the first thing we're using is a simple percussion shaker. And what we can do with that sound is simply use pitch to take that sound into territories that are more suitable for electronic music and very relevant to lo-fi and hip-hop music and electronic music in general. So here is our sound. Simple shaker. However, when we use the SP1200 to do simply what it does, by pitching down, we get aliasing, we get character, we get a whole bunch of things that you cannot get simply from pitching down anywhere else. So check out what we get. Right? You get a now more substantial, almost snare-like percussion element that has body and weight to it. That is the type of thing that you don't get out of that. Like, that really just sounds, yeah, like your typical sampled shaker. You pitch it down, and you get body, right? You get weight. And these are the type of things that kind of punch through the mix, punch through your speakers. Cool. Second sample we have is a woodblock. Very, very percussion-like sound. Same principle. Simple things like pitching down, this is what we get. Right? Same deal. Weight and punch and body, where you get that sort of resonant wood-like feel. However, it takes it more into a uneasy state, right? Just taking your sample simply lower adds that quality to it. Never underestimate how powerful pitching your sounds around can be. They can make the difference between fitting into your song and standing out in your song. And that's one of the things that I hear in a lot of music. There's a lot of times I hear instruments that sound good on their own or sound good by definition. And by that I mean, well, it's a kick and it's loud and it shakes the speakers, therefore it should work in this song. It doesn't really work that way. Pitching your sounds to fit into the environment of your music is everything. Otherwise, it's going to stick out in a bad way and not really sound good. Conversely, you could now take this, push it all the way up, completely different instrument, right? That becomes another element that you can add to your song. Same thing with the shaker. While the shaker obtains a lot of its quality, it can still be used. Now, let's just try and layer these things. That is an amazing combination. It has the best of both of these elements and makes a very heavy sound that could be a snare, it could be a fill, it could be anything you want it to be within the realm of percussion. This is without effects, without anything. Not to mention, you can take this combination as a layer, sample it into something else, and process it further on. All from just simple things that you probably have lying around in your house. It doesn't even have to be a percussion sound. Just simply banging on something will give you something percussive by nature. So I would encourage you to experiment with simple elements such as pitch to enhance your music. Anyway, that is all I wanted to share with you today. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.